I am not standing on a chair. I am standing here with our youngest competitor today, 9-year-old Julian Pavone. Julian, you're 9 years old.
I was 9 a week and a day ago.
So you're one of the few people in the world who make me feel tall, so thank you so much for that, first of all. Now, how long have you been playing the drums?
I've been playing drums for 9 years.
So you just sort of were born with drumsticks in your hand?
Well, I started when I was 3 months old, and then it came to this point.
It's a long 9 years, busy 9 years. Ladies and gentlemen, 9-year-old Julian Pavone.
In my life, I hear love and death and tears.
All right, Jonathan, I have to come to you. What did you think of young Julian?
First of all, you slayed the dragon. It's ridiculous. You sound great. Secondly, I totally want your hair. So I got nothing. You sound really great, man. I think, you know, one of the best things about it for me, I always, you know, when I watch performances, whether it's, you know, rock, jazz, classical, you really want a connection to the artist. And part of it is just you want to see them having fun. And I really see that, you know, like I appreciated that you were back there just smiling the whole time, having a great time. And I really appreciate it because so many concerts you go to and you see people and they play and they're great musicians. And, man, it just looks like they're just working really hard to, it feels like a chore, you know, like they're doing you a favor or something, you know. And I really was happy to hear you today, and you sound really great. Do you have this set up at your house all the time? Here's my dream: is that you have this in your room, and then there's just like a little sleeping bag right next to it, right? Is that?
Well, I have my drum set in my basement. I have a few drum sets. It's sort of like this one, but it's white and a little bit smaller. But thank you.
No, you sound great. You know, obviously you're really young, you're 9 years old. I mean, when I didn't start playing drum set till I was much older than you, 18 years old even. So you definitely have a leg up on a lot of players. You know, I would continue to encourage you, if you're taking lessons or continue to study, to just make sure that, you know, you're developing. And, you know, a lot of times I've seen students where, you know, musically they have a lot of stuff going on in their heads, and then sometimes they get frustrated because they're not able to say what they want to say, you know, in the hands. And you're already doing so much of that at 9 years old. It's really incredible. But, you know, keep developing your technique and developing your skill at the instrument to make sure that, you know, as you get older and start to be able to want to have, you know, more thoughtful things that you want to say at your instrument, that you're able to do that through your vehicle of your hands and your feet, which, I mean, it's really incredible. It's ridiculous. You're like an octopus up there, right?
So. Thank you.
All right.
Judges, we've heard a lot from you about being able to connect the musicality with the performance. And, you know, here's a situation where someone's playing behind a barrier between them and the audience. So how did Julian project himself in performance?
I wrote joy right after your name.
Thank you.
I wrote joy. You just exude it. And the other thing that you do so well already, your stage presence. You're so well spoken already. I'm just blown away
it's
by
the
that.
Hair.
It's
the hair.
But that's no small thing. It really isn't. It's part of, I hate to use the word package relative to a performer, but it is part of it. And you are already so far ahead of many young people. It's phenomenal.
See, I'm going to be the grouch because that's my role anyway. One of the things is you get older and you will notice it. It seems that with a lot of people in the musical community, the motivating ideology is fear-based. And what I love about you is that you are not afraid. Mm-hmm. Do not let anyone ever try to take that from you, because they will try to take that from you. Do not let them take it, number one. Number two, no one will hire you to play that. They're gonna hire you to keep a groove. So when you get older, and it's like one of those great things. Like, I know how liberating it is to play whatever you want. But then when you join a band or somebody hires you to play in their band, you're not going to get to play almost anything that you want. So you still have to maintain that same exuberance and that same enthusiasm playing the most simple things, because that, to me, is the mark of the true musician. The person who can have the same joy playing the role that is designed for them. And then that one solo a night that you get, kill them, knock them out.
Thank you.
But you got to really focus in on the fact that you got to ask yourself as you get older. It's not right now. You don't have to read, but I'm still going to introduce it. When you hear a song, the first question that should come to your mind is, what does this song need from me to make it successful? And that's what you do over and over and over again. And then if you do that, you will be working for a good long time, sir.
Thank you.
Thank
very
you.
Much.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Julian. Great performance.